successful. So we have a panel, a distinguished panel, who was involved and still involved in making this product successful. Let me just introduce the panel quickly. We have Mr. Harsh Shah. Harsh is the first is a CEO of the first InvIT in India. He was involved in formulation of the InvIT regulations, very closely interacting with SEBI over a period of time, and now he's working towards making this product even more popular and easily accessible to investors. We are also joined by Nikhil Naredi. Nikhil is a lawyer with Sharda Ramachand Mangaldas, and he has been involved in a number of REITs and InvITs transactions recently. We are most delighted to have Ms. Asha Shetty, Chief General Manager of SEBI. She's part of REITs and InvITs department, very intimately involved in developing this product and evolution of this product. We will have soon the head of the department from SEBI, Mr. Sujit Prasad, Executive Director. He would be joining in soon to make his comments. The format we will follow for the next 20 odd minutes is to go through a panel discussion. I would request Harsh and Nikhil to make some opening comments and then ask any questions, clarification which they have from the regulator, SEBI. And Shaman has agreed to keep the question answer session. Before I hand over to Harsh, just a couple of comments on this product. He's an expert, but let me just attempt to make some comment. This is a very popular product globally. In India, SEBI introduced this in 2017, and in the, actually the first set of regulations came in 2014, and the first release was tried in 2017. And in the short period of time, it's become quite popular. Now we've got almost 12 REITs and InvITs registered with SEBI. Some of them are public, and they are well traded. There is a need to deepen that further, to go to masses, take it to masses, take it to retail. How can we do that? With checks and balances, we can do that. We will hear from the experts. Harsh, over to you.
Thank you, Sunil, and thank you, Vicky, for having me at the conference. And I think for the last several years, we are participating, and I see the progress of the product year on year on the capital market conference of InvIT itself. To start with, I'll be very brief in saying this is a tremendous success for India, for Ministry of Finance, and for SEBI, of an idea which was started in 2014-15, implemented in 2017, and here we are in 2020, where the overall AUM of InvITs put together would have crossed 70,000 crores in first 3 years of listing, right, of the first InvIT. And I would say this is one of the massive success where in the first 3 years, this amount of capital have been harnessed in supposedly one of the most difficult sectors to invest in India. So I would start by saying kudos to SEBI in terms of building up a extremely robust regulation which balances out the investor protection as well as industry requirement to launch such platform. We did benefit from the global success, as Sunil mentioned. Across the world, there are over $1 trillion of capital invested and owned under similar platforms. In India, we started in 2017, and SEBI, with the foresight, built all the regulations that were needed to prevent any fallout which had happened globally and make the product successful at the first go. So I would say it's a first time right and a first time huge success as InvIT. We ourselves launched in 2017, and today, after 3 years, I think we are tremendously satisfied with the performance. And whatever was envisaged of this platform of either InvITs or REITs, we see it playing out happening. Tremendous amount of capital is getting freed for risk capital in India to go back to new asset, and large amount of foreign capital, both institutional as well as domestic institutional and retail capital have been harnessed into safe assets, which eventually can become a backbone of Indian infrastructure financing. So I think I'll just keep it short, and I would look forward to an interactive session where people can ask questions in that. Thank you.
Before I invite Nikhil, Harsh, thank you very much. Before I invite Nikhil, I just wanted to alert participants that you have a chance to participate in the conference through putting your comments, views, thoughts, questions in chat box, and we will pick it up and make sure that we attend to it. Nikhil, over to you.
Thank you, Sunil, and thank you, Fiki, for giving me the opportunity to be part of this event. It's always been a pleasure to collaborate with Fiki on the various initiatives it take, and this seminar is definitely one of the most look forward event in our calendar. And on the topic that I've been asked to share my views on, it's a topic which is very, very close to my heart. I've been doing a lot of InvIT and REIT transactions over the last 2 to 3 years, and it couldn't have been a more opportune moment for this conference. And we are bang in the middle of the second REIT offering that is going on. I think we will touch wood, we'll soon have the second REIT listed. The public offer is already in the launch mode, and the offer document is already filed with SEBI. So I think it's really a testament to SEBI's effort in getting this product off the ground and making it a grand success. And I want to start with a very, very small anecdote to give you an idea of where SEBI and the other regulators have brought this product to. In the course of our transactions with a lot of global intermediaries, more often than not, when we have described the Indian regulations and Indian framework, I think it's the conversations always start with, we have this similar to what's there in other developed markets, and we have XYZ in addition to that. And the feedback that we've always got from such intermediaries is that, wow, that's definitely an improvement on what people have seen in terms of governance and in terms of protection of the interest of the investors. So that's definitely something that has allowed us to make market this product to a larger set of intermediaries. In terms of some of the details, and the lawyers tend to be boring. So just over the last 2 to 3 months, SEBI has been very, very busy trying to iron out some of the wrinkles in the regulations to make the product attractive to everyone. Some of the long-standing demands of market participants about the regime around change in control, making private unlisted InvITs available as an avenue to investors, allowing sponsors to pledge units of REITs or InvITs to raise financing. Some of these were teething problems that the market participants came across over the last 2 to 3 years. And it would be a fair assessment to say that we've always been welcomed with open arms, and we've gone with our request to SEBI, and some of these recent changes will definitely make the product more successful. So I want to pause here and possibly just go into some nuts and bolts from here on, and hearing more from my panelists.
Nikhil, thank you very much. I think that was a great beginning in terms of setting the tone. I think Harsh and Nikhil, maybe two of you want to interact with SEBI. I'm sure you have multiple thoughts and questions, suggestions, and clarification to be sought from SEBI. Here you go. You've got your chance, and you can interact. And I've been promised by SEBI that they would answer as much as possible. They'll answer our questions. So maybe you can take turns one by one. I'm sure you will have number of issues.
Harsh, you are the elder statesman in this particular field. Why don't you go first?
Yeah. So I think what is there are not much policy level issues left in InvIT regulations per se from SEBI, but I think what I would request SEBI and this forum to take it ahead is to see how different regulator and institutions can be better coordinated when such platforms are launched, right? So I think SEBI, from their wisdom and experience, they launched a phenomenal product. Investors liked it. Market participants liked it. The product got launched. But different regulators like IRDAI, RBI, PFRDA are still grappling with details about the product on how should they look at it. And I think as market participants, we do interact or attempt to interact a lot to showcase our views. I would say that if SEBI takes onus of explaining that, because a regulator to regulator conversation is probably more respected versus from a market participant to a regulator. And if it can be presented strongly in a forum of regulators, that different regulators interpreting the same regulations in different manner is actually hampering not necessarily market participants, but the hampering in which to achieve its true potential, right? Today, India wants to monetize several lakh crores of infrastructure assets. Government of India wants to monetize, right? In a monetization program. Now, unless and until these forum of regulators come up with regulations of different kinds between insurance, PF and RBI, how would that plan really materialize? So I think that's one big push which we would not be able to successfully do from our side. How would SEBI like to pursue it would be a great point. And the second point is, which we mentioned, no country's infrastructure is built on capital. So we'll need to enable domestic capital to be freely invested in InvITs and REITs. For that to happen, liquidity is the single most parameter. And with 3 years of experience now, SEBI has been kind enough to reduce the lot size to 1 lakh. Would there be a roadmap to reduce it to single unit, which enables wider participation, more liquidity, and domestic capital getting tapped for domestic infrastructure assets in the longer term? So I think these are the only two questions from my side.
Ma'am, do you want to?
Thank you. Yeah.
The question, please.
Well, I'm very happy to hear your Harsh say that all policy related matters have been taken care of. But going forward, the point which you mentioned about coordination with the other regulators, we are actively pursuing with them, and you may be aware that they have already enabled investment in units by their regulated entities. But as far as debt goes, they are having certain concerns which we have addressed time and again. And in the various forums that we meet, then we do emphasize upon the importance of this product and how it will help their regulated entities also in the long term. So that is a thing which we are actively pursuing with them, and that is in our radar as well to get it done. And as regards the second question on trading, as you mentioned, it was last year we have reduced it. But we can, going forward, we may, sometime in the future, think of trying to reduce it further, though I cannot commit anything right now.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Very good.
I'm actually taking off from one of the points that Harsh mentioned about investment and which you also alluded to on an investment in debt. There is, in addition to obviously what even RBI is looking at and eligibility of InvITs and REITs to raise borrowings and even external commercial borrowings, some kind of direction that all of us are looking from SEBI is the ability of foreign portfolio investors to invest in listed debt of REITs and InvITs. I think that's another sort of some direction. We've spoken to regulators in the past, but just wanted to hear your views on how you are approaching it and if we could get some more clarity around that. Ma'am, you're on mute, please.
Thank you, Nikhil. As you may be aware, our regulations are currently enabling even FPIs and other entities to invest. But then it is RBI who is the primary regulator who will enable this kind of an investment and to what extent it will be done. So this is one more area where we have already written to them and we are in dialogue with them to enable it, but we have to just wait and see what is the response which comes from DASA.
Sure, understood. And the other sort of broad picture point that I wanted to highlight for your consideration, and SEBI's been very, very proactive in ironing out all the regulatory gaps. For example, over the last 3 to 6 months, the entire regime around rights issues, preferential issues, and sort of institutional placement, the QIP equivalent for REITs and InvITs have been clarified. And that really gives some bit of a light on how sponsors are looking at setting up these structures in terms of future fundraising. But there are a few more gaps that we like in terms of post-listing life that needs to have some clarity on. For example, buyback, delisting, redemption. So we know that the regulator has engaged with market participants on this. And just to sort of get a little bit of idea, because what it helps is that it helps a lot of the new entrants to plan their overall strategy. While we understand that this doesn't come into play right away, but when we are advising some of these sponsors and financial sponsors, they are able to take a longer term view once there is clarity on these aspects as well.
We have had a recently we have amended our regulations wherein we have allowed entry and exit for the sponsors and other investors who may want to come in. To a certain extent, I think that will take care of the question which you are raising. And as regards having a regulation for buyback and delisting, actually this product is fairly new right now. So you have to envisage a product, envisage a framework for buyback and delisting is too soon. But if it is there, I mean, we are working on it. So maybe sometime later on we can discuss and have some kind of a framework for them.
Ma'am, if I can come in here, and I'm getting a lot of feedback through the chat box from the participants. Number of them are suggesting that they want to hear from you. Any guidance you would want to give in terms of how SEBI looking at strengthening these products? I mean, you made a good beginning. There was a new policy framework which was laid out. This product was tried very successfully in the market. It has now established, it requires to now go to the level two. What is SEBI's thinking in that direction? So I've been getting pinged back to ask this question and say they want to hear you. So why don't I request you to make some comments?
But as regards the way forward, what we have started doing right now is all the post-issue obligations, etc., have been inbuilt into our regulation and circulars. And from SEBI's point of view, we have also started off with monitoring, checking the monitoring and compliances of the REIT and INVIT to ensure that they are compliant with the various norms which you have mentioned. So one part is the regulation to be put in place. Second part is whether the compliance of these regulations are being seen to by the REITs and InvITs. So going forward, that is what we have started. We have started last year in a small way. So going forward, we will be covering all the REITs and InvITs who are there registered with us currently. And as in market participants do make a request, so this is the product framework which we need, obviously the policy changes, we need all the communication dialogues with all of them and putting our policies according to that.
You know, it's sometime we hear this discussion in media and this point keeps coming back. Private REITs InvIT versus public REITs InvIT. Is SEBI likely to take a view on this or what's SEBI's view? I don't want you to say anything which is non-public or any policy related issue, but broadly, is there something which SEBI is thinking about?
In case of InvITs, we have only enabled actually the public and private listed and even the unlisted InvIT. As far as REITs are concerned, we have only enabled the public REITs as of now. Because I think worldwide also there is no such product which is there. So currently, the focus which we have enabled on the inlets, that is the structure which we have put in place.
I was just trying to see if Mr. Prasad is out of the meeting, but he seems like he is still in the meeting. So why don't I just get last word from Harsha Mittal, if they want any other question, if they want to make some last comments. Because it seems like Mr. Prasad is still stuck. He may not be able to join this.
Yeah, he's not back as yet. He's not back as yet.
Harsha Nikhil, one last point.
So thanks, Sunil, and thanks again, Vicky, for having us here. Last point I would make is that we believe that infrastructure financing is going to be largely done by InvITs going forward, and we'll see a flurry of InvITs and capital mapped on this robust regulations in the country. And where we are today is an inflection point where the regulations are robust. Global investors as well as domestic investors have given thumbs up and own several assets, starting from road to a transmission line, to a gas transmission line, to commercial real estate and telecom towers via InvITs and REITs. And I believe that with where India is in terms of macroeconomics and fiscal needs of monetizing more assets, and where the global capital flow is with seeking good yield, this is the perfect place where a large amount of capital will flow in and large platforms will get built. I would conclude by congratulating SEBI for this tremendous success, and I would recommend that they beef up the team, because this market is going to become as big as the other markets in mutual fund or others that you have successfully launched and made such a big success. So all the best, and we're all excited for the journey ahead. Thank you.
Okay, excellent. We need to close this session because our next session is ready, and we have to log in. First of all, thank you very much. Thank you for two reasons. A, for explaining, guiding us, giving all the clarifications which we needed, and B, stepping in at the last minute. I know it's not easy, it's difficult. Mr. Prasad was called for an urgent meeting and you stepped in. We really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please wait. We will be back with the next session in a couple of minutes with the Chief Economic Advisor.